On a normal afternoon in December of 1989, the Chiu Yong Kee Cha Chan Teng, Hong Kong-style cafe, in Tai Po Tin received a phone order for 4 people's worth of food to be delivered. Upon his arrival to the flat, the delivery boy rang the doorbell, and the door opened just a crack. Money was slipped through this gap and the person in the flat asked for the food to be placed outside. The staff didn't think much of it and headed back to the restaurant. When the owner cashed out the register that night, he discovered a stack of hell money burned by locals for the dead to use in the afterlife. All of the staff claimed to have nothing to do with it, but a couple of days later, there was hell money in the cash register again, making the connection that a delivery had been made to the same apartment again that day, and thinking it a tasteless prank, the furious owner demanded that he will deliver the food if another order from the same address should come through. Sure enough, they received a call the next day, so the owner made the trip himself and tried to peek in through the gap when the door opened. He couldn't make anything out and left after making sure the money he received was indeed Hong Kong dollars, tucking the cash away separate from the rest of the day's earnings. That evening, the money had once again transformed into a wad of ghostly notes. By now thoroughly spooked, the owner immediately reported it to the police. When the authorities forced their way into the unresponsive apartment, they discovered the grisly scene of 4 dead bodies prone on the floor. By the state of their decomposing bodies, they had been dead for some time, but their neighbors claimed to have heard the sound of mahjong, Chinese tile-based game, playing coming from the flat recently, and so didn't even think anything was amiss. According to what was known, they had died for about 1 week or so. The bodies were sent for autopsies and the hell money that the boss received was sent for analysis. Inside the bodies, they found food that seemed to be consumed within the last 2 days. These foods were from the restaurant. In addition, the hell money that the boss received comprised a few fingerprints, the delivery personnel's and the corpses. The real cause of death is coal burning emits too much carbon monoxide, causing 4 people after inhalation, poisoning and dying while sleeping. There were stories about how that could have occurred, primarily that the 4 dead didn't know that they had died and therefore continued to order food. But what's even more intriguing is this: all scientific evidence has pointed to a supernatural occurrence, and no foul play could be done after the intensive investigation. Most importantly, there has been no closure, the authority has sort of just let it go. Do note that Hong Kong is a developed country that believed a lot in science. The evidence is still there, and the events are still unexplained, unless you don't rule out the fact that the dead could walk. The history of the Cecil Hotel is so dark and gory that some say all 600 rooms are haunted, but one creepy mystery is still yet unexplained, the mysterious death of Elisa Lam. The strange behavior of 21-year-old student Elisa Lam was captured on security camera at a Los Angeles Hotel Cecil on the night of her disappearance. Her death is one of the most mysterious cases of the 21st century. On February 19, 2013, some residents at the Cecil Hotel complained about the water quality. Sent to inspect the cause of the blackened and odd-tasting water, a maintenance worker made a grisly discovery: the decomposing body of Elisa Lam in one of the roof's water tanks. For about 19 days, residents at the Cecil Hotel bathed, drank, and brushed their teeth with corpse-contaminated water. Even weirder, the hotel remained open and guests continued to check in and out as firefighters removed Lam's body. During the investigation, police came to know that she, at first, was living in a shared room with other travelers, but later on a complaint by her roommates specifying certain odd behavior, she moved to a personal room. After that, no one saw her leave. On February 15, 2013, after 2 weeks of the disappearance of Elisa Lam, the Los Angeles Police Department released one surveillance video from the Cecil Hotel. This surveillance video went viral on the internet and drew worldwide attention to this missing case of Elisa Lam. In the pixelated video released by the Los Angeles Police Department, Elisa Lam can be seen entering into the lift and pressing all the floor buttons. She steps in and out of the elevator. She peeks out sideways toward the hallways of the hotel. Before leaving the elevator entirely, she peers out the elevator for more few times. All these behaviors are strange as well as creepy at the same time. Many theories evolved with her actions in the surveillance video released by the Los Angeles Police Department. In one of the scenes, Lam was acting like she was running and hiding from someone and also can be seen making various hand gestures. 2 weeks after the odd video of her in the elevator was released, maintenance worker Santiago Lopez found Lam's body floating in one of the hotel's water tanks. Lopez discovered her body on February 19, 2013, after several hotel guests had complained about low water pressure and a weird taste in the tap water. According to the Los Angeles Fire Department, the tank in which Lam was found had to be drained completely and cut in order to fit her body inside of it. She was discovered wearing the same clothes she had on in the elevator surveillance footage, and her body barely had blood due to the decomposition. Lam also had all her personal belongings and her room card with her, floating near her lifeless body. Her parents, David and Yina Lam, filed a wrongful death lawsuit against the Cecil Hotel, but the hotel's lawyer argued that the establishment had no reason to think that someone would be able to get into one of their water tanks. Lopez confirmed that statement by explaining that in order to get to the water tanks, several alarms had to be turned off and someone had to have climbed a few ladders to reach the very top. If any alarms were triggered, the front desk would have been alerted as well as the first two floors of the hotel. Ultimately, the lawsuit was dismissed as an LA Superior Court judge ruled her death as unforeseeable, as no guests were granted access to the water tanks. Not long after the Cecil Hotel in Los Angeles opened in 1924, a guest committed suicide in one of its rooms, beginning a decades-long string of murders, suicides, or otherwise unexplained deaths on the property. Is it a mere coincidence, or is there an underlying dark force that ties together the spooky, sinister incidents? The controversy still continues. Created by Investigation Discovery, Horror at the Cecil Hotel is a TV series based on all these bizarre incidents happened at the Cecil Hotel that has gained huge popularity and is highly rated by reviewers.